In this video, I will be working with GNS water-based resist, a clear and non-odorous silk resist. This product comes in several sizes, from small right up to the 1 liter size. Now, in order to add color to your resist, you are going to need a small jar with a lid. I'm using a baby food jar that's been cleaned out. You can work with either French dyes or Prussian dyes. In my case, I'm using silk paint, yellow silk paint. And you'll also need a jar of water. Now, to mix the batch, you will require something like a butter knife or a bread knife. I'm using a butter knife to take out the resistant. You can see how thick it is. It sticks right to the knife. You couldn't really draw at that stage, it's too thick. Always have a paper towel handy to clean your tools. Using the butter knife, I'm removing a small amount of resist and I'm going to put it into the small jar. Use the quantity that you feel you require for the job. Try to always have a fresh batch. In other words, don't make more than you need. So, I'm going to add just a little amount of yellow paint. I don't normally work in yellow, but this is just to give you an idea. You can mix it whatever color that you want. So, mix vigorously. Notice it's still sticky. So, we need more liquid in there. I'm going to add more yellow paint. Once again, mixing thoroughly, and it's still quite sticky. Now, in this case here, I don't really want to keep adding color because it's not going to change the intensity. So rather than adding paint, I'm going to add water to make it, to liquefy the resist. And mixing very carefully again, it's breaking down and becoming a lot softer. But I test it by holding it up and see how it drips off, and it still needs more water. So a little generous amount added. Okay, it's looking a lot better. Very liquidy. Let's hold it up and test it to see. Yeah, and look at that. It's pouring off the knife like warm honey. Very good. We're ready to pour into the cone. This is my homemade resist applicator. I made it using acetate. I just turned it into a cone, almost like a pastry chef tool. So I'm going to pour the resist from right into the top of the applicator and let it pour and run down to the bottom. Look at how fast that's pouring in. Nice. So as we hold it up, you can see how the resist descends on its own just by the force of gravity. Look at that. You can see it going all the way to the tip. There, it's now ready for use. Okay, now sometimes you'll need to store your applicator. Here's a simple method. Get a tissue towel, crumple it into a ball, put it into a jar, and simply let the resist pen sit in there. It'll be just fine until the next use. Now that your applicator is ready to use, I want you to practice using this tool on simple sheets of paper. I wouldn't want you to start working right away on silk because you need to get a sense of how it's used. Now, what you're going to do is hold the applicator near the top, squeeze and move the pen lightly over the paper. So you're squeezing continuously and very gently and making the resist pour out at the end, but you're not pressing into the paper, you're gliding over the paper. So look at how easy this is. Very clean. The more you practice, the better you'll get. Remember, it's a squeeze, a gentle squeeze, continuous squeeze, and moving of the pen over the silk and you end up getting these beautiful lines. I have my drawing ready here for adding the silk to it. This drawing has been sprayed with artist adhesive. I did this outside and I let it dry for 3 minutes. So now that it's dried and ready for the silk, I'm going to simply place a piece of silk over the design. This is just to give you an idea as to how I work resist into the silk. Okay, we're ready to add the... I'm adding the resist on it. It's no different to when you were working on the paper earlier, except now you're working on silk. So it's the same process. You're squeezing and moving your hand at the same time, but you're not pressing into the silk. Look at that. Look how easy this is. Very clean. I'm going to change the resist color just to give you a better idea. I'm going to use an old color. That this acetate cone is about 2 days old, and let's see if it works. Okay, oh, it's a little hard coming out. There we go, it's working. Okay, so look at that. This is from 2 days ago and it's still good. This is a darker color that I had mixed earlier. So you're going to complete. Remember, when you're applying resist, you don't want to put your hand over wet areas. So be mindful of what areas are wet and what areas are dry. Taking just 15 minutes for the resist to dry, and I'm now removing it. Look at that, the lines are perfect. I'm going to test it using a bit of paint, and you can notice that it's going right to the edge, and it is sealed. This is how you want to do it. I'm going to show you how to make a resist applicator. I'm using paper instead of acetate right now, just so that you can get an idea how it works. What you want to do is hold one corner, your left hand, at the top right corner of this paper, which is 8 inches by 4 inches. Twist once, hold, flip, and then you just tighten it up like you would make a cone for a pastry chef tool. I'm going to do this again using acetate. So. Here's the acetate, it's 8 by 4 inches. Holding it at the top left corner, I am going to have some tape in my hand as well. So we're going to flip the acetate over to the left. Turn once, hold at the front, and then switch hands. And here you tighten, and you can adjust the hole at the tip by pulling up or pushing the acetate together. And just look at that, we've got a cone. I like the size, so I'm going to tape it up. There we go. And this is it. A few tips on your resist. Always store it in a refrigerator or in a cool place. And the manufacturer estimates that it can last up to 1 year. Remember to never use spray adhesives indoor. They're highly toxic, although they're very effective in melting silk. But I recommend that you use in a well-ventilated area outside. One important thing to remember when you're storing your silk which has just had the resist applied to it, to never store it in a warm or hot area. If you do this, what will end up happening is you'll end up getting a transfer from the dried resist, which I think the paraffin bleeds out, and when you try painting to the edge of the silk or the resist line, you will have a great difficulty. It'll always remain white. Another thing to remember is that have very clean hands when you're touching the silk or doing anything with the silk. because if there are any oils on your skin, it'll transfer and it'll show up on the painting.